Look happier.
Wow, this is really like 15 foot.
Focus out there, it's focusing on the windshield and all the raindrops.
Well, since that's all we see, maybe that really seems to be pretty well.
Well, it's raining. We're here in the Olympic Peninsula, and true to the reputation, it's raining today. It's been raining for how long now, Ray? Since at least noon yesterday. It's about 9 o'clock now. So it's been quite a long spell. It's been sort of moderate rain the whole time. So maybe at most 5 minute gaps in it. A couple times last night. Now it's not it, otherwise just steady. Today we're moving between the coastal part of Olympic National Park, down north of the Kalaaloq area, north of Queets, up through the heart of the peninsula really, and moving north and to the east over toward Port Angeles. And we're thinking that a motel might be a good thing tonight.
Definitely.
This would be the second time then that we would have stayed in the motel. And just kind of let it rain. There's been a fair number of logging trucks by here. And they do a lot of logging through this country. We're actually on private land now outside the park boundary. See the landscape is fairly bare of trees right here. No, I can't. And that's of course just all the private lands turned into dollars. There are a number of Indian-owned lands also around here. Of course, the Indians also use the rivers and other resources of the area. But little in the way of like Indian gambling, although Indian fireworks has been a big thing in this country apparently. There's lots of little fireworks booths owned by Indians, especially back south of Seattle, we'd see those. Yesterday we went up into the whole rainforest, and again they had very large trees of the mature forest, this time fairly heavily covered with mosses and lichens. But since the redwoods, it's been one place after another claims the biggest spruce or the biggest Sitka fir or whatever. And I guess we've seen enough of the biggest of the trees. They're nice still, it's just don't need to take a lot more trails that say, here's the biggest of them. We didn't necessarily get all the beach that we wanted, but it was pretty nice when we were there. We had a very nice sunny day, and that's when we explored the tide pools for ourselves. Yesterday we took a long guided walk, and it was good tide pools, but I guess we knew pretty much everything she had to say. Ray's only going about 85 today. except for that here, isn't it? Hook, E-D-I-Z, of Port Angeles. It's been still rainy and basically a little foggy.
A little?
Well, kind of, yeah. Off to the left there's moorings for logs out there for the Daishowa America paper mill, which is up ahead here along either side of the road. It really looks pretty much like a private road through there. Here's a place where the trucks come and just dump their logs in the water, I guess. You can kind of see the plant up there.
Fog here because of all the steam they're releasing right there?
No, I don't think that makes too much difference.
No.
I would imagine. It's just over the water here, that warm, moist air that's been coming in, making rainstorms, is condensing over the cool water here, I guess. So, not the most stunning view here. On the right side, I suppose waves washing over this whole spit here. And to the right, then, would be the Strait of Juan de Fuca. And you can see some of the log rafts out there. Well, we can see them. There's logs out there in the water, waiting to be hauled into this mill here, I guess, to be made into paper. Suddenly is there out of the mist.